everyone. Welcome to Jump STEAM at Home. I am Sister Pieta.
I'm Tate Ralph.
And we are biomedical engineers here at Jump. So first of all, we want to tell you just a little bit about what we do here. So one of the things that we do is we help our surgeons surgical plan for their to take care of complicated patient cases. So we do a lot of heart defects, we do some orthopedic cases, so people with broken bones or getting an implant of some kind. And we also do a lot of our surgical planning now in virtual reality. But it all originally started with print. So we actually have a couple printers in the room behind us on the other side of that wall.
So a 3D printer is like any printer that you have at home, where you are right now, hopefully. Except instead of printing a single layer, it prints many layers on top of each other until you build up a line. So we use that for a lot of our hearts, our different anatomies, different body parts that we have, and we use to help doctors learn more about their patients so that they can provide better care for them.
So this is one of our patient hearts, and it's the actual size. These are all the actual sizes of our patient's hearts. This is the size of a newborn heart, cut into three sections, and this one is a young child, probably about 1 to 2 years old. And they actually have a hole in between the atrium, so the top chambers of their heart. So it's called an atrial septal defect. But we can print these for our surgeons. They can see them before the case, actually see what's going on with their patient's anatomy, and they can kind of plan in their head what they're gonna do with their surgery.
So outside of the stuff that we normally do, we also are able to do a lot of different things with science. And so we thought that a good way to, you know, have something to do in this time when we're all safely in our homes, we would do a few science experiments for you guys and kind of give you a sense of what maybe you could do if you have some extra time on your hands.
So this first experiment just involves four things. You'll need a jar, a hard-boiled egg that you've peeled, and a candle or a piece of newspaper and a lighter. So you're gonna put your candle or your lit piece of newspaper into the bottle. And then after it's had some time to heat up the air, not very long, you can actually take the egg, ours has a face on it, and put it on top of the bottle. And you're gonna notice that as when air heats up, it expands. So the flame or the newspaper that was on fire causes the air to expand. When the egg was on top, it cuts off what the fire needs to burn. So when you cut off the oxygen to the fire, it will actually put the fire out. So you saw that the flame of the candle went out. Because the air was heated, it had expanded, but when the flame goes out, it actually cools, and that cooling brings all the air back together because it condenses, and it brings that air back together, and then that's what causes the pressure to drop in here, which sucks the egg like a vacuum into the bottle. So that's why the egg actually fell into the bottle. And if you wanted to, you can reverse it by pushing more air in. So if you've got a balloon at home or different things like that, if you flip this over, you can actually put something on it and force the air in, and that will actually draw the egg out. Well, I hope you enjoyed this week's experiment. We'll see you next week at Jump STEAM at Home.
Bye, everybody.